Person eventuell so einen Sitzhocker?
Non sprendo il...
Oh, sorry. A seat for an old woman? Maybe a seat to...
A chair or something.
A chair.
We don't have any... This lasts for an hour, so... It's 1 hour. So she has a problem.
And over 80.
We do also
okay.
stuff with moving
okay.
and...
Yeah, okay.
I'm so sorry.
Please don't actually touch or hang from the curtains because they're very fragile.
It's okay, just keep in mind that you shouldn't actually lean back. If you don't mind, please don't stand up. And come closer. Come closer. And closer. Is anybody that cannot understand English very well and needs to be translated in German? Everybody can? So, let's come even closer to each other. And let's hug each other. Let's close the circle. And if it goes to the back, many people, that's why we do that. And please feel to express your borders when someone tries to contact you, to touch you. And please, before you try to contact someone else, to touch him, ask him if he feels okay about what you're going to do. And let's find out how women and men and every gender in between feels about that. So let's say half of the circle, let's make a closer circle. Let's say the group that's outside will participate in a second time, but let's observe how this group is going to react.
So the question is how effective we can be with each other. So we can try touch and ask by asking and see what are the boundaries.
Is that affectionate that you step on her?
Yes. And I asked before, and she asked me not to do it too heavy.
I won't do this.
Thank you.
Anyone wants a massage?
I can.
Massage? Would you like?
We're jealous.
We can massage each other.
If you need a massage.
You can go with each other.
Can you give us your feedback on why you're leaving?
Because I need to go to the toilet and I have stomachache. No, really.
So maybe now the second group would like to join the first, the newcomers. Απλά λίγο πιο να με χωρέσουν κι αυτοί.
Can I give you a hug? Can you give me a hug? Hug is okay?
Like him.
I would like to remind you that we have to try to speak one by one as much as possible so we can be comprehensible also for our viewers online. And okay. So, no, I know that you won't meet each other. Or
continue.
No, sorry. No, I thought you won't say something. Try to see our boundaries one by one, or you can start, for example, and tell me if I can touch your leg, or until what, like here is okay, but where is not okay, stuff like that.
Really, the leg, everything is okay.
So I can touch here, I can touch here, until where?
On the leg is okay. No,
but
problem.
This is okay. This is not. But what I can do?
I try to think as you after you ask me, right?
Okay.
Harassment will be you touch me any part without
asking.
Yeah, asking me or without connecting me, because you don't need or not ask that thing. Mm-hmm. So.
But do you have different? Like for you, is it the same? Like,
well, I guess asking is a good way to start.
Would you accept the touch from me, but not from here, or the opposite? Does this relate to if I'm male or female or something like that?
Probably not.
Okay.
So the asking thing is more important
than the gender thing. Do you all agree with that, or do you have?
Yes.
And it's a question of sympathy. So I think it's not more or less a question of gender. It's a question of whether I sympathize with a person from some gut feelings at the first. And of course, the way you ask, okay. The way whether I want to get to know you,
okay.
And all those kind of things. And then it's all fine.
Or of your smell.
Or the smell, yeah,
yes.
The same.
Asking your smell is very good, but if you smell bad, you can ask anything.
And it's the environment, so if it happens in a supermarket, probably I don't want it. Here, it's okay.
It's also bad.
Now with someone
who comes in.
You never know.
Like I find that it's complicated to think about it. Like when it happens in the supermarket, you don't even have a chance to think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? In this, you need to realize what you are telling us to do, so that takes time to analyze what is expected to, so that can.
But would you accept from a woman a more intimate touch than from a man?
I think it's also a question of nationalities. Like for Spanish, the boundaries are very soft. In many ways, like I remember the first time I went to England, people jumped when they touched. For us, it's a little bit more relaxed. You feel more comfortable close.
Okay.
And in other countries, it's a little bit. I think actually it's a distance between different countries.
Mm-hmm.
You go to Cuba, everybody's relaxed in the bus and nothing happens.
And what's your border? What would you say it's your border for a stranger to touch you?
Can be my finger, really. Like, I don't think it has so much to do with like a part or something.
Mm-hmm.
It's more like somebody come touch me in a less intimate manner. I think that's enough. Just a touch. Right? It happens sometimes, somebody push you on the street. And you feel that it's not like nice, and sometimes it's an accident, you apologize, whatever. It's a feeling you don't.
How about you?
Me? Yeah.
Can you speak up a bit, just so I can hear you?
Yeah. I think it depends on the situation and where you are and who it is, though. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I think it's not only a question of touching, it's also a question of distance to each other. For example,
here, what is the border here?
You asked for affection.
Mm-hmm.
When you guys started, it was about affection, and affection is a relation. So it needs to be built. So perhaps in my case, it's no way enough intimacy here for me to develop a relation that can take me to affection, and there will be affection for human beings. What maybe doesn't take me to hug them or kiss them, but just to feel for them. And it's different. Like, mm-hmm. I think that's a not discrepancy, but it's something that one thing is like to move together, to be close or something. Another thing is to show affection. That's, for me, it's a huge difference there, right? Without being contrary.
And regulations, and as long as we work within these rules, even surprises are okay. You're getting to know someone you would never get to know at another place or another environment. But I can imagine if someone steps out of and somehow doesn't work with the rules anymore, starts to whatever, to shout very loudly or to slap people into the face, to give some very extreme example, there would be a boundary, so there would be a border. The group probably would solve that. That would be an interesting case, honestly. So to see how the group probably reacts on that. Because we all have these rules in ourselves now. Hopefully. And we can work with them.
Why do I touch somebody? Is it because I want to touch her for an experiment, or is it because I don't know, I want to hurt her, or it's different. Here I think people are friendly, I suppose.
It's like a game, perhaps.
Yes. It's not real life.
No, it's under control.
Yes.
The street is not under control.
No, it isn't.
I don't know what is happening.
Yes, it is.
It's a personal question, actually. The persons that didn't interact with strangers at all, why is that? Of course. There were some persons that didn't interact at all, even with their friends. And I'm interested, genuinely, on why didn't you try to come closer?
Yeah.
maybe it was because it was such an artificial situation in here. So it didn't feel naturally. It felt like people feeling a little bit forced to leave their comfort zone. And it didn't really feel like affection, or at least for me it didn't. So I talked, for example, with my brother, who I feel affected to for years now, and we haven't seen each other for some time, so we talked to each other and just caught up with some topics. But I didn't really feel affected to anybody strange of the group. And I think if somebody would have come to me, I would have joined probably, but I didn't feel like outgoing to go to the others and interact with them.
I'm sorry.
The room as such is not encouraging, not inviting to talk to each other. The echo here is incredibly high, no interior. So my first idea was, let's go out into the green and talk there about the nature and things.
And about something, you find no common topics here without the scene you set us in. Yeah, this is for me the problem, to find a thing to speak about with somebody.
Without talking, can you feel affectionate for somebody single by touching his hair or his cheek?
Yes, I can take contact, for example, with this lady with this amazing shirt she wears. Yeah. But you have to find a topic, and only to be to stand here in the circle, and now you are asked to speak to somebody only by having you into the eyes of somebody standing opposite of me. It's difficult to find a common topic to speak about. Besides, how do you do? Yeah. How are you today? How long have you been on the Documenta? Those silly questions you are perhaps you have in your mind.
I agree that outside it would be different and more difficult maybe to ask someone to touch you or something, but I feel that here I could be touched everywhere by anyone. So, because it's this performativity of the space maybe, and so does anybody else feel like that? And like, it doesn't belong to her or his body? Or? Yeah. Do you feel that your body belongs to you so much here, or you could somehow sacrifice it for proving or no? But
how can your body belong to you if you cut your leg? Is it your something different than, or without legs or with legs? So how can your body can be your property? Does it change your soul or it change your everything?
I say that it doesn't mean that it's my property because I'm getting paid.
Yeah,
so.
But how it's be your property? Maybe there is some parts of you which is already you cut your leg, you have no leg, and well, does it make your sense? Soul or something in your other things? Are you without your body parts or without your hair? You are not you?
And maybe it's that because I'm getting paid to be here, so I feel that I don't choose every day to be here. So I feel that I could be elsewhere. Otherwise there's a reason I'd be here. So if there's a discussion about body, I can give my body. But maybe from your point of view, it's different.
I think that is just an instrument. What can you use for a time? Only instrument.
If someone wants to go, it's
Can I need to film the feedback.
My old aunt is waiting outside, so I have to go. Because
thank you very much.
But it's very nice, but I don't like the room. And it's a little bit pity that the room is such strong. And the acoustic is also not so nice. But that's not going to be you. You are great.
Firstly, you said that here in this space you feel that it's a performative space, that everything can happen, and you would give permission, mm-hmm. if I understood. Mm-hmm. And then you said that you feel like your body doesn't belong to you, and I don't understand what you mean. I'm just curious. What
yeah.
does it mean that your body doesn't belong to you?
I don't know. I feel that I have to be here, bodily I have to be here, and after time it's not, you don't choose every day to go to work, for example. Sometimes you just get your body and you go to work physically, and maybe your mind is elsewhere, and so I felt that I had to at least give the body to this experiment.
Like treating this as a work, because you are at work a bit.
Yes.
And you are making something.
Yeah, so I felt like that, yeah, I have to, so it doesn't feel weird in my mind.
Can I suggest something? Yeah. Do you mind while you're discussing that you actually touch in some way, maybe hold hands? What do you mean? No, I meant the one that you're talking to. Because it does change how you see the other.
Are we finished?
Yes.
So if you're standing next to me?
Yes. We could put this room, for example, if you want that.
I was looking at someone else. Yeah, why not?
That's
okay. Hmm. It's a little bit, yeah. I think it's really hard that you put up affection in one word with like touching people, because I think feeling affected is not so much about touching people. Also, when a relationship to somebody you get to know develops, you normally don't start with touching. Maybe when you're very, very drunk, but also not. So I think this is really hard to feel affected to somebody who you just get to know. So I think this is really a problem of it. At least it is for me.
But can it work the opposite? Can it work the opposite way? Can it work the opposite way that you get closer faster because you're obliged to touch?
Hmm. Maybe if you're kind of forced to, I don't, like not forced to, but if you're encouraged to touch each other, maybe if you spend then a longer time, then you together you think maybe back of the moment you touched or so, and then you feel affected faster. I don't know.
Let's see how it's gonna work after a while.
Let's see. What's then around with this? Doesn't feel too bad. Feel a little bit like
it's
a
like we're taking a picture of you now. Does it feel any different? That you talk to him and you are touching him?
Actually, it was harder for me to look into his eyes than to touch his hands, because this eye contact is always like you recognize immediately when somebody reacts to something, and so, yeah.
had during your discussing now a common item. Meanwhile, standing so close together, it seems to me like two statues clutched together. In comparison to this couple here, you see they have an emotional thing. So I think touching follows the emotion. It's not the other way around. You often see in the news people spontaneously touching them, but the reason is emotion. In the stadium or after one of those
fun, or grief,
for example. So a common emotion.
Can I hug you?
Pardon?
Can I hug you?
Ob sie dich umarmen?
Ja. You can.
Was there any change in the way you see me or how you feel?
Perhaps a little bit more sympathy could be.
Well, we tried that for many years. May you tell me your name, please?
People start to stare at you. So there's even more pressure on interacting somehow and maybe doing something creative. And then there was, so as I didn't really interact with somebody, there were a lot of people imitating the others. Like as soon as somebody started something, somebody else was okay, I hug you as well, or I stand on your feet, or I do this or that, but somebody else just started.
I think what might be helping in or might help in the beginning was if everybody moved, then it would be easier to get into contact because you could look at people first and get to know them a bit. And so I found a distance or the gap from being here by myself to getting involved with somebody else very wide.
You were the first person I hugged, right?
Yeah.
Didn't that make it a bit easier for you to cross?
Not really.
Would you like to do it now?
Oh, maybe I can change the sign.
I can help you.
Thank you.
About sharing, and you were talking about you don't exactly, maybe I misunderstood, but you don't exactly have
to know each other, but you have to have something in common. I've had a lot of people actually in the football stadium which I don't know. It's each time when you share that maybe very clueless moment there, but it does provoke something very spontaneously. When you read 20,000 people coming for the same thing. Maybe we're not here for the same thing.
Why are we here? Why are we here?
I work here, but I participate. Yeah, but I participate also because it's kind of interesting, and I want to see what happens next.
And you?
I don't know anymore. curiosity. But did I come to share? I don't know.
I was just intrigued when the door opened and I randomly walked by. So I just thought, okay, there were so many people standing in front of it, and I thought, okay, let's just get into it. So then I was standing here, and I thought I'm not particularly fond of physical contact, but the nice lady invited me. I still stay because a person once told me that I need to get through uncomfortable situations, so that's what I'm doing right now.
Did we come here to share somehow something?
Work also, if you have other purposes, you have such kind of goals. So you say, okay, I go to a conference, or I go to a meeting to share. Here, most of us, I think for me at least, are interested in being surprised, finding out what's going on. So this is sharing can happen throughout the whole thing, and probably something will change over the course of the whole thing. And when we walk out, we start to share, for example, what we like about the document or not. But personally spoken, I have to say, I came to see the concept, so the method, and not to share with people. It's interesting now, because we are, while getting to know the concept, while getting to know others, we also start to share immediately. But it was not the first thing for me.
We have been here for 15 minutes. How do you feel now about the same concept that we told you about when you came? Do you feel more connected to each other? Would it be easier to touch each other?
Not really. I think it's interesting, the question of sharing. So what we come to exchange in the space, And I think somebody already mentioned something. There is a little bit of how you come to a situation of affection. It's not easy. But maybe the setup I find very harsh, extremely harsh. The camera is harsh. That thing there is driving me nuts already.
She's asking me.
People watching, you know, like in the films or something. It's kind of weird. It's a very cool space for any type of relax. It looks like the patio of a jail, you know, like it's really a place to count almost. Count how long will last. So it's just, it's nothing given to provoke us to share. I can say, like, performance could provoke us to enter situations that we can alter something in us, but it's harsh, the environment, I find very harsh.
Can we alter the environment?
Yeah, in many ways, like, I don't know, maybe personally, maybe can do with a sofa or some pillow on the floor or something that relaxes.
But with our physical presence, with our...
We do, mm-hmm. And I think when we get close, or we're getting close, but it's also forced because it's a camera and they have told us, or you have told us, to stay 1 hour, and it's something that we are supposed to do, so everything is expected from us, too, a lot, I think.
from my point of view. So it's like somebody was saying, I need to go to do, so what I want to do I want to get affection or give affection to someone? So I look for somebody, hey, maybe I go and get affection. She looks great, yeah, she looks very nice. So really, like, you try to look for a way, not a connection of a theme, how you say? For me, it's not, because we weren't expected to talk, we were expected to touch, so I want to touch. So then my boyfriend is here too, he's like, do you mind if I go touch the guy? So, you know, it's all these things too, and how much can I? No, but it's kind of funny because he's just asking me to give affection, so when I give affection, it's sexual, it's not sexual. If I give it to a girl, it's not going to be sexual because it's a girl, maybe. She likes her, so for her it's going to be super sexual, right? So it's a lot of things that I can keep thinking, but it's nothing given for me to enter the actual action of doing this, right? I feel like I'm being watched, I'm being closed. It's just hard. For me, it's hard to.
Honestly, I've been in this room this afternoon, and I saw, in a way, me on this on the monitor, the group of yesterday, and this still remains in my head, and now being filmed again. Of course, I think about tomorrow as someone watching me, and I don't have a problem with, I don't have a problem with that, so because it doesn't have to be super smart or something, but talking about sharing, creating intimacy, I think, which is the main thing that we should create to start a relation, start some kind of trust. There's always an exit, always a, let's say, like a secret dark hole open in this room where the energy flows into the unknown. And I don't know what the people on Facebook are doing right now. Do they like it or
they,
don't like it?
It's
or
not
whatever.
On Facebook.
Yeah,
it's
whatever
on Facebook.
Whatever you do with
yeah.
it, you're allowed to. But it's not very helpful to create a trust.
Mm-hmm.
Trust and nice intimate room.
Well, I find interesting that today
but
it was. I find it interesting that today actually there were no hidden traps. There was no agenda on what we're doing. It was explicit from the beginning, and I don't think it was so forced to touch in some way. I do believe that the talking part actually maybe should have been in the beginning and then should have been the touching, because that's how the human psyche works. All in all, I do believe that in this room we managed to change how it feels, because you are 100% right. To me, it's a mental hospital. It's unbelievable. You can leave, it's all white, it's weird. But I do think that this group managed to overturn the power of the room at the end.
I don't know. I as I said, I think my boundaries was not me being touched, but as me touching somebody else, and that this is what I felt about boundaries. I didn't have any problem to be touched, but I had a problem to touch. So it was kind of uncomfortable somehow in some moments I felt, but and it still is, you know. I can still see that we are kind of I don't know what it means though. I cannot understand what it means.
Chooses for itself if it wants to be surprised or not.
even if I come here to be surprised, my body, a lot of bodies are like, I don't know.
Maybe it's even that some of us, or you expected that your artists would surprise them, and not the participation that you actually need so that anything can happen here.
How much we are a group and how much we are separate from them outside of this room, which I think was is the result of the last 25 minutes, it's the result of